Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Some people arguing here. Forte's mother says he's practicing music at the lighthouse. Forte's father says, are you thinking what I'm thinking? Forte says, what are you guys talking about? The father says, he's been acting weird lately. It's possible that your grandpa's thinking about going on a trip. The mother says, it looks like he was planning this for some time already. Really? Says Forte. Father says, you didn't notice? How old do you think he is? He's 62. I don't care if he's still young at heart, but it's too reckless to go on a world tour at his age. Even though he thinks he's still a kid, it's more like he's going off to die. The mother says, you're so right. I'd feel safer if he went up to the mountains to fight some monsters. Right, the father says. Is that so, huh? Says Forte. His mother says, what should we do, honey? His father says, If we asked him about it when he wasn't thinking about it at all, that might make him want to do it. And it would have the opposite effects. You know, Forte... It's like I'm crashing into him. What is it, Dad? You go talk to him casually and find out about it. Me? We're counting on you, Forte, his mother says. Father says, good luck. You guys always put something like this on my shoulders. Father says, you guys are good friends. Just go chit-chat and find out. We are counting on you. Okay, we're done talking on this matter. Done deal. Forte says, you're nothing but an old fox. He called his father an old fox. Jan says, woof. Are you telling me to do it too? All right, I will. Father says, we need to stop him if he is really thinking about going on a trip. You and your grandpa are good friends, so can you ask him in a subtle way while chit-chatting? Oh, there's something there. I see Grandpa looking at the sea alone, his mother says. He's also practicing the hand harp sometimes. I wonder if he's really serious about going on a trip. It's been almost 10 years since he quit as a troubadour. He may be itching to start again. Almost 10 years, huh? What's here? Oh, it has Water Melody by Leon Friedrich Richter written on the front cover. This is the book which Grandpa's old friend from his trip sent him. It looks difficult. Do you want to read Water Melody? I'd say no. We just read it in the beginning. We'll just look through it. Yeah. I read this in the beginning of the last episode. Wait, I thought this book was so rare. They have a copy too? I can't imagine McBain just gave it to them. He was looking for this thing all over and all the time it's just sitting in their house. Forte says, it's similar to a bedtime story I read when I was small. I think I still have the book at home. We don't have the book, right? No. It stays there. Forte says, you'll feel refreshed after you take a rest here when you're tired. So you know, my bed is the right bottom one. You could sleep wherever. Who's he talking to? The dog? It's pretty much first come, first served, wherever you feel like lying. We should sleep while we can. Not yet. There's something over here. Oh, I want to look at that too. You really like fishing, don't you, Grandpa? Well, I guess... Okay, he lives here too then. Alright. This fish is a good size. I think it's better to eat it than to mount it. I guess the grandpa lives here too. That makes sense why the book's there then. I've had this picture book since I was small, but I wonder how long my family is planning to keep it. The title on the cover reads, The Awakening of the Arch Enemy. Yeah, we'll read it. A long time ago, there lived a people on this earth who were called the Water Tribe. The Water Tribe was very wise and had a variety of knowledge. They were led by their wisdom. The ingenious Water Tribe eventually devised magic spells, which proved to be very useful. If they called for the wind, it came to them. If they called for flame, fire would burn. People's lives became much easier thanks to the spells created by the Water Tribe. The blacksmith would use fire spells to light their furnaces. The tool merchant's wife would use water spells to help her do her washing. Kind of reminds me of Harry Potter with the Weasleys and all the dishes and stuff, everything cleaning itself. The young man living next doors would use darkness spells when taking a nap. Everyone used the spells they needed, however, something terrible happened because of this. People were using so many spells that the arch enemy, sleeping in a faraway mountain, got angry and woke up. It was a huge, dark arch enemy, even bigger than a house. Everyone was in trouble now. People gathered and discussed what to do. What should we do? The blacksmith held his head in his hands. The arch enemy plans to eat us all, said the tool merchant's wife. The young man living next door started crying and said, I'm horrified. We shouldn't have used the spells. They were all too scared of the arch enemy to do anything, so they went to consult with the Water Tribe. The Water Tribe suggested that they try singing a lullaby. A lullaby which would put the arch enemy back to sleep again. The voices of the Water Tribe rang out. Sleep, sleep, arch enemy, please fall asleep. The Water Tribe continued singing with their gentle voices. And then they say that again. Then a miracle happened. As soon as the arch enemy heard the lullaby sung by the Water Tribe, it became sleepy and went back to its mountain. Once there, the arch enemy rolled over with a loud thump and fell into a deep slumber. The arch enemy went to sleep. The people were overjoyed. The arch enemy never woke up again. It was the sound of the spells that had disturbed it. The Water Tribe warned the people not to use the spells anymore so that the arch enemy wouldn't wake up again. How loud are these spells? Since then, the Water Tribe have never shown themselves. They have gone home to a faraway place. Thus, the people stopped using spells and no longer needed to worry about waking the arch enemy. No one uses magic spells anymore, lest the arch enemy awaken again. Okay. Well, I got two more books to add to the... Sorry, I bumped the table. Two more books to read to add to the... Let's read the books of the Gagrav trilogy. Okay, so that's where this goes. So McBain is either down that way, where he went before, or... Oh, that's it. That must be where he is. Because there's nothing else here. Well, we've already been that way. But we stopped going that way. We started getting into battles and stuff, and I figured, well, we're supposed to talk to people first, right? So I imagine he's down that way. Let me just double check around here first. Oh. What's that say? Oh, see you later? Is that what it says? Your dad asked you to find out in a subtle way if your grandpa was planning to go on a trip? I think it's a waste of time. Do you think so? Says Forte. He's been practicing his instruments. What matters is when he's planning to leave. Grandpa Mac is at the lighthouse, right? Why don't you go talk to him, since your dad wants you to? Well, I would if I knew where the lighthouse was. Let's put it that way. Oh, he won't let me through. Alright, never mind. This is obviously the way out of the town. I figured the lighthouse might be in town. Wait. Well, might... I figured a lighthouse might be separate from the town. That's what I meant to say. Pad says, Hi, Forte. What's up? Nothing much. I just saw your grandpa walking towards the lighthouse. Yeah, he goes to the lighthouse ruins alone when he practices. Oh, ruins. We saw something that looked like a ruins. Pad says, why does he go to such a lonely place by himself? He told me that professional performers shouldn't practice in public. He also said that the only times they perform in public is when they receive money. Busking. I see. I think your grandpa's cool, Forte. I'm sure he'd appreciate that. Alright, we gotta go find our way back to where we were. We fought those monsters or monkeys. They were monkeys? Whoops. Oh, okay, now we got it. That's like a ruins kind of thing. I saw that before. And this ends here, I believe, and this steps down. That's where the well is, right? Look at that. Is this a lighthouse? It looks kind of lighthousey. Grandpa, are you up there? Are you really there? Bow. Bow? It's pretty dark inside this lighthouse. Besides, some doors don't open. This place makes me a little nervous. It's not because I'm scared or anything. Bow! What is it? Anyway, we better find Grandpa. I'm gonna go see. That's the name of the place. I'm gonna just look to see if there's anything else before we go in there. Because there's these steps down, and I think I took them before. That's where we fought those monkeys. Oh no, the monkeys were before that. I'm just curious where this goes. You never know, if we get caught in some cutscene, we might not be able to get back here. It's so rusted that it doesn't move at all. Okay. Well, that's what's over here. So the lighthouse is kind of like a dungeon, huh? See, I've been in one lighthouse in my entire life. And it did not look like a dungeon. There were a lot of stairs, though. I need to go to more lighthouses. Not dungeon ones, though. I could skip that. I could do without that in real life. Don't jump! It's much higher over there. Alright. Oh, there's monsters! There's monkeys. Why didn't you defeat the monkeys? Oh, we never rested. We'll be okay. Down a few points. You're a pretty good team, huh? Hey, don't hit my dog. One-shot it. Nice going. That's a good boy. Alright, we got more stairs. This isn't anything, right? Oh, it is. Oh, wow, we're outside. Do we want to be outside? Let's just see. Oh, there's nothing up here. I'm trying to explore all I can without running into a cutscene. That's why you see me so hesitant. I figured he'd be standing up there, McBain, and then we wouldn't be able to go up here. But I'd be willing to bet he's at the very top. Just to see if there's more, any more doors here. So this section doesn't have doors to the outside. I hear you with the hand harp. Yeah, I don't think those are doors. Standing up here on this thing. Oh no, he's over there. McBain was concentrating on playing the hand harp. Grandpa. Wow, he's great. What do you want, Forte? I have a question. You've been practicing here often lately. Does that mean... are you planning to go on a trip? Or are you planning to enter the Pinzel recital? Who do you think I am? There's no way I would participate in an amateur's recital. So, that means... did your dad ask you to find out? My mom, too. Both of them are very worried. It's nothing to worry about. Oh, so it's just their imagination, Forte says. Wrong? What? When I go on a trip, no one can stop me. That's why I said it's not worth worrying about. Didn't look that old. So, you're leaving... when? Don't be so anxious. I'm not saying I'm leaving right away. I'm getting old. I just started practicing to prepare for my last trip. Same difference. You're planning to go on a trip. It's none of your business whether I'm going or not. Don't tell me what I can do. You're interrupting my practice. Go away. Oh. Grandma Shella at the processing factory said she had something she wanted you to help her with. If you have time to come after me, why don't you go help Grandma Shella and Una? Now, get out. You're interfering with my practice. How rude. If you have time to come after me, why don't you go help Una? And get out again. Okay. Is this where the light comes from? This thing? Very unusual. I guess a flame comes out the top or something? Alright, guess that's it. We found out what we wanted to find out, right? I guess we're heading back to his parents. Quite a walk. I forgot. It's not them. It's down here somewhere. Oh, I know. Left from the pier. Forte's mother says, I see Grandpa looking at the sea alone. He's also practicing the hand harp sometimes. Oh, she said that before. Okay, I can't talk to them about what I found. Alright, so I guess we're gonna help Una after all, since that's what he told us to do. I mean, we're a young boy. We just have to do what we're told. Forte, can you come over here? I have a favor to ask you. Oh, the dog just goes to sleep. We are short a delivery person. Yeah, I know. What's his name? Doesn't want to do it. You think we can deliver? You can deliver some dye stuff to Kranka with Una? Una's, like, blushing. Aw, she's trying to set him up. I don't want to send Una alone there. I can do that, says Forte. I knew you would say that. Una? Yes? Can you go to Kranka with Forte to deliver this dye stuff to Caparo? Alright. Forte, do you remember where Grandma Caparo's house is? Grandma Caparo's house? I'm not sure. Her house is located right after you enter the village of Kranka. You remember there is a stage in the village, right? Her house is to the west of the stage. Gotcha. Una says, it's been a long time since I went to Kranka with you, Forte. Una joins the party. Here is the dye bag that you need to deliver. Forte and his friends receive a dye bag. Watch out for the monsters. The monsters which appear around here are not very strong. Well, they're monkeys. But if you don't stay alert, they're gonna hurt you badly. I know. I'll be careful, says Una. Thank you for doing this. You're delivering this to Grandma Caparo and Kranka, you know. We know, they say. Jan, says Una, why don't you come with us? Woof. Alright, let's see if these people are, see if there's anything other to say. And I can count on you. You deliver it to Grandma Caparo in Kranka, okay? However you say that name. Kranka isn't too far. Don't go overboard and go to Pinzo. Don't get lost. You go too far, it'll be too hard to come back. And you're the one that just doesn't want to deliver it. You saved me. Are you really going to Kranka for me? Thanks. I'll stay here and work hard. I kind of like a low-profile job. I'll turn over the delivery to you. Be careful on the way. Yeah, you'll turn it over. I understand. So... what does she have? She has a target bow and artist clothes, like Forte does. I just want to see the description of the target bow. Actually, can... I'm not sure. I'll just see. I'm gonna try something. Bow used for archery games at carnivals. Looks like a toy, but best for beginners. I want to see if there's a way to look at it without de-equipping it. No. Nope, not that I can tell. Alright. I'll talk to his parents again. Maybe they'll say something now. Trying to report my findings on Grandpa. Welcome, Una. How are you today, says Una. Una, I heard that you're helping at the dye factory. You're such a good girl. I wish Forte would be as good as you. Forte says, I sometimes help, too. I make deliveries. As a matter of fact, we're on our way to Kranka to deliver dye stuff. Only sometimes. You're doing what you want to do for the rest of the time. I wonder, who do you look like? I guess I'm Grandpa. That was quick. It's Forte. Who do I look like? I don't want you to blame it on me, says the father. Despite my appearance, I'm very good at skin diving and catching shellfish in the raging waves. I contribute to the village. Okay, okay, the mother says. Be careful. All right, says Una. Forte, how is Grandpa? Father says. First of all, we have to make a delivery to Kranka. I'll tell you after we come back. Wow. You don't want to say anything? Okay, says the father. I don't think going to Krenka is that dangerous, but you still need to be careful. Alright, we'll be careful and get our rest this time. We should sleep while we can. Maybe he was saying that to Una before, and the game didn't realize that we could go there before we picked her up. Unless he was talking to the dog. I don't know why I always sleep on my stomach, says Forte. Because it's comfortable? Why else? Okay. I thought this might be another room, but it's pretty deteriorated. I should fix this place up a little. Alright. Let's go talk to everybody else, and we'll check on Grandpa again before we leave. Maybe he'll come with us. Hi, you two, says Una's father. Oh, that's all he says. Mother says, Forte and Una can get along very well. Okay, you're talking to Forte and Una. I guess we got some more translation issues here. With your girlfriend? Cool! Where are you going for a walk today? We're not telling you. Alright, let's exchange our stuff, see how much we end up with. 100 gents. Or gents. I don't know. I'm gonna call it gents. Alright, so let's get... three cure bottle S's. Three leash bottle S's. Oh, I don't want to use up all my money. We got a purify potion off one of those monkeys. I forgot to have him steal something again from one of the other monkeys. Lackety paste cures paralysis. This neutralizes poison. Restore snuff. Okay, we can't afford that. Marbles. And lackety paste is 30. Okay, I'm gonna get the lackety paste. Just in case we get paralyzed. Now we're broke again. Thanks a lot, man. Thanks a lot. Making us broke with your merchandise. Oh my god. I think Forte's about to throw up at this point. I'm gonna talk to everyone before we leave town again, including Grandpa. Oh. Okay. Howdy. Hey, yo, says Forte. Howdy, says Una. I think your grandpa's cool, Forte. I kinda like that. Hey, yo. Hey, yo. Hey, yo. Are you going to deliver something as a favor for Grandma Shella? That is a nice thing to do. Be careful with the monsters. Okay. We're not leaving just yet. I'm not sure if we have one or two more people we haven't talked to since we picked up Una. Oh, some boxes back here. Let's bust these suckers open. can find some more of those monkeys, and then we can go back and buy the marbles. Which I'll probably never use. So I'm gonna talk to Grandpa McBain one more time. Hoping he'll come with us at this point. That's the easier way in. I think. How do we get up there? Oh, wait a second. Sure, where to go. Whoops. Get up there. I guess you just walk across this way. Yeah. Anything new with the well going on? Luna says, Forte, your family uses this well every morning to get some water, right? It must be a hard work since it's a little far from your home. Forte says, I'm a man, so it's no problem. Besides, we take turns in the family to go draw some water, so it's no biggie. I kind of like to go to the well when it's still cool in the morning. Makes sense. Alright, let's check in on him one more time. If anything, Una might have something new to say. Forte, don't interrupt my practice. Go away. Una, take Forte somewhere so that he won't bother me. Forte, Grandpa Mac is mad. I'm not mad. I just wanted to concentrate on practicing. Oh, you're grouchy. Okay, I guess that's it then. Yes, it's time to leave the town. Okay, next episode we'll be leaving the town to head for this, whatever this place is, with the dye bag. A bag containing dye to be delivered to Grandma Capero in Krenka. So we're heading for Krenka. Oh, we got a new book, Playful Birds. The pleasant sound of Piccolo resembles birds singing in the trees. It do? Okay, we got a bunch of stuff. We got this from a monkey and we bought the rest. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.